Boom! All right, Lance Sumner here. We're going to talk about ClickMagick, setting up a custom domain, and why you should be doing that, and also why you should have ClickMagick so that you can use it to track any of the promotions you're doing, any of your marketing efforts, and see exactly how well that traffic's doing to each of your sites, you know, your landing or capture pages, and just be able to really monitor and hone in on what's doing well and what's not. So anyway, I've just got you where you can see ClickMagick, and ClickMagick doesn't cost much at all for what it provides. That's what I will tell you first, everybody listening out there. Whatever business opportunity you're in, ClickMagick works for it all. Okay, you just be able to set up, be able to do split testing, rotators, set just one single link. Whatever, I'm just going to show you that we're going to log in here. And then also why you should be setting up a custom domain instead of using just the ClickMagick tracking link. It just is, it's more professional and it just works well in different locations such as on social media. All right, so when you log in here, if you went into ClickMagick and you just wanted to create a link, a tracking link, you can go to the links at the top and you would just say create a new link. I've already set up a custom domain, but we're going to walk through the steps so you understand how to do it and whether you're using, and I use GoDaddy, and you can use Namecheap, and one of the places that you can find exactly how to do this on most programs anyway, and especially here at ClickMagick, is just go to the help, go to the frequently asked questions and knowledge base, and check over there and type in setting up a custom domain. You're going to get some guidance and some steps, but I'm going to take you through it in a quicker way on screen so that you know exactly how to do it fairly quick time. So anyway, here, so if you were to come in and set up a link, you just give it a link name, no test, right? This is my custom domain, retiredlivinglife.com. But if I was still using the same and I didn't set up a custom domain, I would still have to use the ClickMagick link and my user ID here. And then I would put whatever I want here, such as, you know, free giveaway. Yeah, I'm going to give something away. And then you would just run that, and whatever your giveaway link, affiliate link is, you would put that in here. So I'll just use this as an example. Put that in here. And you can cloak the link, set it up so that they will only see the ClickMagick link, free giveaway, and they won't see your affiliate URL. Or no, you just want to track it. And then you would just hit create. That will create your link. And it would show up as a preview link. I'll just do it here real quick and I can always delete it later. Give you an idea what it looks like. All right, so let's find out where we put that. Test. So here's test where it's at. We're just gonna pull up, and right here you'll notice that this is the actual tracking link, and you would be able to click preview and it will show you whatever affiliate link you used in there. So you would take this and then use that in your marketing efforts, wherever your ad copy, emailing your list, solo ads, Facebook advertising, being whatever it is you choose to do. But I want to give you an idea why ClickMagick is so good. It's because it allows you to look at things. And you can set up even funnels in here that has specific links that you can, entry links that you can set up to a funnel that can track conversions and everything else. And I'll just show you a quick glimpse of that. But anyway, here in the links, I'm just going to go back to the links real quick and give you an idea why this is really cool. So if I went back to, I'm going to go to my first page, and I just want to show you, just to give you an example. You can, here at this 4% sales video, you can see I just started a little bit of marketing, just a little, and you have this cog. You can do editing over here on this little pencil mark, but you got this cog. Click the cog. You have a lot of choices to look at things, track conversions, but I really like looking at this, traffic quality. This is how good this system is. It'll tell you the type of traffic you're getting. Okay, so I had a traffic quality score of 74. It's getting up there where it ought to be, closer to the green. 91% tier 1 clicks. Awesome. okay? And tier two clicks, they were mobile clicks. And so you see, this is why it's important in your marketing to have the details of what's doing what, so that you can kind of hone in and say, oh, I'm getting a lot of nice mobile traffic. I better make sure that my pages are mobile optimized. See, so you want to be able to check that and make sure you're using a, whether it's lead pages or click funnels, something that allows your pages to be mobile optimized instead of some of the cheaper versions that people have out here on the net, such as, here, we'll create your landing pages, capture pages, you can have it for $7 a month. Well, you're not going to get very much with something usually that cheap. Not that will do what you need it to do. So anyway, I just want to give you an idea. That's traffic quality, and it has all these other features, as I showed you over here. You could be able to look at some of the stats, all these different things. But now I want to go over here to funnels real quick, and then we're going to get into create that custom domain real quick. So let's jump over here. See how quick it'll pop up. So you can set up some funnels, and when you do that, you can create entry links. But what's good about that is, and I'll give you an idea, I just set up a couple entry links on this one here. You can have, as quick as we'll move, you can have entry links, and you can set them up by, set it up by traffic source. If I'm going to send something in my out to my email list, maybe AWeber or GetResponse, or I'm going to set up a link, entry link that's connected with this funnel, and it would be go run off over on YouTube. Okay, so I'm able to look at, and I'm going to go back here, able to look at the reporting. You have reports you can look at with this. Gives us some options to look at the performance, the stats, and everything. And also, as you're using those entry links, we'll show you, and I've only started a small amount of marketing efforts here, but you can see, okay, these all, you can scroll over the top of any of these to see what it is. Unique visitors, actions, it should be like actions, sales, okay, it shows where sales of a unique customer, percent actions, conversion rate. And if you clicked on this funnel, you would be able to see what the funnel looks like. See, isn't that cool? Gives you opt-in page, sales page, thank you page, and it takes it through the whole funnel and then gives you the actions occurring in that, in those stats. Okay, so anyway, let's get off of that, and let's go to create the custom funnel. All right, so if you're going to go over, what you would be doing is you would, like I said, you would go over here and you could click on your frequently asked questions. You would look for custom tracking domains, and you're now going to say, well, what is the recommended way to set up a custom domain? And I just want to show you, and you can follow these steps, but really what's important is you can also follow the video. Okay, you can set up a with your actual domain like I did, www.retiredlivinglife.com, or you can add a little kind of a sub domain type in the front, like track dot whatever your main domain is, such as mine. If I put track, it'd be .retiredlivinglife.com. But I don't do that. I just wanted to use the actual domain. I think it looks better for what I'm doing. And you would just follow these steps. You can follow the steps, or you can come down here and watch the video to do it for Namecheap, GoDaddy, right? So we're going to show you how we're going to do that with GoDaddy real quick down here. So I would come over to my account, GoDaddy, and I'm already set up to go at the specific domain, Retired Living Life. So what you would do is when you log into your account GoDaddy, or you're going to go purchase a custom domain, whether it's Namecheap or GoDaddy, I recommend either one of those. You would get that name, and then when you log in, you'll normally see the domains, but if you don't, you can just go to all products and then go to the domains. And here you would just go to the domain you want, manage, click on manage, now we're gonna, and when this page pops up, you're gonna scroll down a little bit, you're gonna manage the DNS. Okay, I'm gonna manage that. Now we're going to look at the records here. Records. What we need to do is add, just like it said back here, we need to set up the CNAME record. Okay? and what that needs to be. Now, if you're going to use track, you would have put that, and I'll show you over here. But what we would end up doing is we would go down to here to add on the records, and we'd choose add, choose CNAME, and it's going to pop up in your host. In this case, it's going to be for me because I would like my domain retiredlivinglife.com to get picked up either way, retiredlivinglife.com or www.retiredlivinglife.com. And here we're going to put www, and it's going to point to, and for ClickMagick, they want you to set it up. Now, if you're going to use, you're going to set this up for use with just the tracking links, you put this right in here, www.clkmg.com, which is ClickMagick, or for if you're going to be using rotators, you would use this one, CLKMR. But we're going to use the first one. Take that, copy that, right-click, copy, back, right-click, paste that in, and set the TTL to a half hour as best, and then you would hit save. I'm not going to hit save because I've already done it up here, as you can see. So up here, CNAME, www, ClickMagick, half hour, all set. Okay? So once you've done that, now if you wanted to, you would do this too, and if you're going to do the track thing, you would do the same thing, except here, CNAME, you're now going to put track instead. And that's going to add that little subdomain part to your actual domain name. And you would still leave it on a half hour save, and it would add it on here. I didn't do it, don't need it. So we go back here. We check to make sure we've done everything that we're supposed to. Right? And it tells you here, choose half hour. Real set, real straightforward. And but it doesn't matter. Actually, these steps work pretty much the same, whether it's Namecheap, GoDaddy, whatever. If you, it's just an understanding of what you're looking at, going to the DNS and, you know, the record and the host name and stuff. So I think if you'll just take your time, go through the steps, it's pretty easy. Or watch the video. Watch the video, pause, do, start it, pause, do. And so this is just some additional things if you wanted to do something. Not necessary, actually, in my opinion, not necessary. And so now, once that is done, now we want to test it and check it, okay, in ClickMagick. So we just drop that X down here. We got to go to back to on Tools. We're going to go to Tools. And we're going to click on Domain Manager. Okay, and now, what is my domain name? So I'm going to put in my domain name. RetiredLivingLife.com. And I set it up in the CNAME DNS or a record for use with tracking links. Cloak with this domain. Now you can leave it no for now. You can mess with that later. But always read whatever these directions are as you're going through it. Read first. So I'm going to say add, and it's already added. So let's see what it says though. Oops, go back because it was already added. So when you put yours in there, it's going to come up and say right below that button, it's going to say domain added successfully, but mine's already added. And so that's where this comes in. So I want to go and set up a link real quick, and I want it to look custom instead of like I showed you earlier. Go over here, create a new link. And get back to there again, create a new link, just call it test 2. Now I'm going to leave it my customer domain. Now I have a choice. That when you set that up, it'll all of a sudden show up in this drop-down box, your custom domain, and you pick that. And then you give it the name you want, test 2, whatever. And then you put that affiliate link in here, primary, and then you create it. And now your link is going to be the HTTP www dot whatever your domain name is and whatever sub title you gave it over here in this little field, and you use that for your promotions and marketing. So this is what I use for myself with 4%, the 4% challenge, which is, it's an outstanding program, and this is for anybody out here. And I'm going to show this additional piece with you. ClickMagick is a vital tool for your marketing efforts, tracking the quality of traffic, how your ads are doing with any of the landing capture pages you're using or funnels that you've set up. and which ones are doing best, which ones you can shut off, and which ones you need to focus on because and continue to optimize to increase your profits and people coming in, right? So, and this is also about being able to do things efficiently and allow you to build your list, which most business builders know that's an important aspect about building a list and being able to share and correspond with your list and provide added value and help other fellow entrepreneurs be successful online. So, but as with 4%, I'm part of that. And so we've set up a funnel in here that allows you to use this custom domain now along with the affiliate links of 4%, but nobody has to see, and we've all seen it. We've clicked on something and the link that pops up in that little address bar at the top up here is some long, ugly link. Some long thing we don't even want to see. I'm like, what's that? I don't know if I want to click anymore. Well, that's why we set up a custom domain, because it's more professional, more legitimate. And so this is why, you know, it's a better deal. So anyway, I highly recommend that if you don't have ClickMagick, that you go ahead and check under the video. Take a look at ClickMagick. Get this, use this tool. It will definitely benefit you. And anytime you need any help, feel free to reach out to me in the information that's provided below the video. Touch base with me on Facebook or any of the means I leave. And I'm here to help other people be successful, whatever they're doing. And if you're interested in actually creating a life that only most some dream about, then feel free to take our challenge, a 30-day risk-free trial. Take the challenge. It'll be below the video. Gives you an opportunity to check it out. Detailed step-by-step training, foundational, exactly what to do, what tools to use, build and grow an income, and keep increasing it. All right. Well, I hope this was helpful for you. And so use this to your advantage. And I'll see everybody next round when I pop up with some other tool that I believe is of very good use for everybody out here trying to build a business. Have a great evening.